That was Shinko Basky performing the commission work that was by Deborah Cheetham called Long Time Living Here. Shinko's coming off stage and we're preparing to go into the first piece of the evening. It's Dvořák with Carnival Overture.
Thank you.
Jacinta Parsons, here with you on ABC Classic, and the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra is in full flight this evening. You just heard the Dvořák's Carnival Overture. Ben Norby is bowing. People are throwing ham in the air. It is an absolute scene of joy as he comes off, and I'm about to go on stage right now. Let's do it. Wow. Hello. That was just the beginning. Can you believe how beautiful that was? Round of applause. Lord Mayor Sally Capp, are you happy with that one? She's given it two thumbs up, Melbourne. We are doing very well. I think it's time to welcome back the conductor, Benjamin Norby. Look at him. He's like a rock star with a mic.
I'm not going to sing, that's for sure.
Could you do you're not going to do any, hits of memories?
No, nothing like that at all. I'll stick to waving my arms in the air for a living, I think.
You do it very well.
Well, it's just wonderful to see so many people here, and these free Sidney Myer concerts are just one of the great things about living in the city of Melbourne. It's just wonderful to see the city of Melbourne turn up to an event like this. So thank you all very much for being here. Thank you.
We are on ABC Classic that's going right across the country, but surely they all know Melbourne is the best place right now. Benjamin Norby, Dvořák, so beautiful to kick off the program this evening.
It's a wonderful concert opener, full of life, sets a carnival atmosphere, and we've got a concert really all of dance-inspired music, and there was lots of toe-tapping going on there. A little bit windy on the stage, it has to be said, and that's one of the great challenges with outdoor concerts. Every now and again, when it's very windy like that, you'll see that there are so many pegs on the musicians' stands as they peg down their music to... There'll probably be an inner-city peg shortage, actually.
Surely we could have done something progressive in our whole life. There's still a peg.
It's funny you should say that, because I've worked out the smuggest people in the world are those musicians using iPads for their music. They are the smuggest people in the world. I asked for a pencil the other day to borrow a pencil. They just looked at me like I was crazy.
Granddad, what are you doing? Now, Benjamin Norby, we're about to move into Bartók's Miraculous Mandarin Suite. Obviously, I am the layman here. Mandarin, anything to do with the lovely fruit?
No, it's nothing to do with the fruit. No, different definition
just checking,
of Mandarin.
Just so we all know.
Look, it's the first of our ballet scores tonight. The second half, we're going to be hearing one piece of music by our own Elena Kats-Chernin, which is music for a ballet with Wild Swans. Ravel's La Valse, which was actually originally intended to be a ballet but got knocked back, wasn't good enough, but that's been a staple in the orchestral repertoire ever since. But first, this Bartók, wonderful music of the early 20th century. Béla Bartók, Hungarian composer, modernist, my favourite era of orchestral composition, has written a ballet score. It's quite a sordid affair, this ballet score. I won't go into too many details.
Don't go into details.
But other than to say that it is a tour de force for the orchestra, a real chance for the orchestra to show their virtuosity. It starts in an urban cityscape, a metropolis, and Bartók described it as a kind of urban nightmare. And you can hear a lot of this kind of suspenseful grotesquerie in this music. The clarinet features very, very prominently in this. There are three episodes that are for clarinet, and the whole piece ends in a very frenetic chase scene. It's a lot of fun to play and to listen to.
Urban nightmare and grotesquerie is what I'm taking away from this. Hold on to your loved ones, because we're in for quite a show.
Thank you, Jacinta.
Benjamin Norby, please, and the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra.
Thank you.
So Ben is the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra receiving a huge, warm round of applause from the Melbourne audience here at the Myer Music Bowl. 10,000 people standing up in their seats, in fact, as to how much they loved that piece. A complex and wonderful piece for this program this evening. We've got so much coming up that we'll be sharing with you in a moment, and it's coming out to say hello to the audience. Wow, was that not incredible? And a huge round of applause for those clarinets, especially there, Philip Arkenstall. Wave to your mum, Philip. There he is. Now, we're going to let the orchestra take a little break, which means that you can also take a little break. But I have to tell you that after this intermission, we have one of the most spectacular second halves that I think you will have seen in years. So get your hot chips, have a cuddle, go to the toilet, and come back. And we look forward to sharing with you the second half of Dance, Dance, Dance this evening with the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra. And for ABC Classic, we're just about to be joined by Deborah Cheetham, who is the composer who brought to us that beautiful acknowledgement of country earlier in the program.
Thank you. Thank you.
Absolutely phenomenally beautiful ballet suite, Wild Swans, there, performed by the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra live at the Sidney Myer Music Bowl here in Melbourne. And you would have heard smattering of applause throughout the entire piece there. What they were clapping for was Emotion 21, the beautiful dance troupe, who came to the stage tonight and brought that ballet to life. You can get onto the MSO YouTube, to their Facebook, to their Twitters, their Instagrams, all that stuff. And they've filmed it, and you can actually watch it back and enjoy it in its entirety. The audience is absolutely going wild. The ensemble is waving to a crowd that has jump to their feet. It is so beautiful here this evening. They're taking their time to enjoy the space with the audience right now, and they are now coming off. Ladies and gentlemen, let's really hear it for the dancers. Emotion 21. Noonan. And please keep your applause going for Yaron Lifshitz and Libby McDonald from Circa, Contemporary Circus, for the choreography of that dance. Congratulations. Ah, did I not tell you? Did I not say that would be one of the most beautiful things? People are still standing up because what a wonderful treat that was. There's tears down here. I can see them. And I'm sure they're right through the crowd this evening. Again, how good is it to be in Melbourne, hey? Here for the MSO and the wonderful orchestra that we have that is such a jewel in our crown. He's worked very hard. So I think we really need to give him a little bit of oomph to bring him back, the rock star of the conducting world, Benjamin Northey.
Best introduction ever, Jacinta, thank you.
Well, you're wearing the T-shirt tonight.
Well, it's
the
summer.
The guy's pretty cool, hey?
Well, I'm trying my best at my advanced years to look cool. Yes, that's right. But wasn't that amazing? What an extraordinary thing to be a part of.
I don't know how we can keep going. It was one of the most beautiful things I have seen, and I did warn you. So I'm glad you are. We will be going home with our hearts swelled. It's wonderful to have something like that as a collaboration with the MSO. We've seen some beautiful collaborations this evening. Again, we're so lucky to have this orchestra and the work that it does.
Well, that's what it's all about. That's what music can do. It brings people together and it gives us these kinds of experiences that, as you say, really do warm our heart. And, you know, we've had many of them over the years here at the Myer Music Bowl. It's just wonderful to be able to share that with the people of Melbourne here tonight, something so special as those amazing dancers from Emotion 21.
Yes!
So incredible.
And when you jump on the tram on the way home tonight, go, guess what we just did? Something really cool. Were you there? Now, we've got maybe one more, maybe another if we're very excited. The next song, is it song? It's not.
Song.
Oh, I gave it away.
Song sounds good.
I was trying to act cool.
Hey, you're talking to the rock star of conducting.
True.
It's a song. It's a song.
A track, shall we say. This one, Ravel's La Valse.
Yes.
Tell us about that.
Yeah, a little bit about this. So Maurice Ravel, French composer, this piece was written in 1919. It was originally called Vienna, and it's meant to be a tribute to the Viennese waltz. And because of its timing at the end of the war and the collapse of the Austrian Empire at that point in time, it's become associated with kind of the demise of empires. And it's a waltz, and like a, there's nothing that has the potential to capture the feeling of spinning out of control like a waltz does, and that's what Maurice Ravel does with this piece. It just builds to this inevitable climax from its smoky beginning, so you can imagine dancers in a big Viennese palace dancing to La Valse, and then everything just getting a bit crazy.
I can imagine that's going to happen up on the hill, maybe? Some dancing. This is your opportunity to dance on the inside if there's not enough room. But also we get your feet are moving. Benjamin Northey, thank you very
thank
much.
Thank you, Jacinta Parsons.
Please make
thank
the MSO
you.
Very, very warmly welcome. The orchestra is tuning as I walk off the stage, backstage here at the Myer Music Bowl. You are on ABC Classic. And how lucky are we that we have these wonderful performances broadcast live for you this evening. As I mentioned, you can check it out. You can have a look at it for some time on. We're about to start now. Another beautiful performance of Ravel's La Valse there, the MSO, the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra, in front of their home crowd who have loved every moment of this concert here at the Myer Music Bowl. The sun has definitely set, and as they get to their feet, I do believe they are asking for more. Their Norby's just come off stage. I can tell you, he's drinking out of a water bottle that says Ben on it, just in case. He's taking a deep breath. There is sweat on his brow. Standing beside him. And they are asking for more, and Ben's just returned. Ben Northey, conductor here of the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra, returned to the stage for an encore. Have they got it in them? That's the question. I think they do this evening. He's taking a bow. He's going to let us know himself, actually, this evening, what that encore might be.
Is it okay? Is it okay? Oh, dear. There we are. Is it okay if we play one more piece of music for you, everybody? Thank you. That is the correct answer. Congratulations. We'd like to thank you for coming and sharing your Saturday evening with us here at the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra. Please don't let this be your last visit to the MSO. We've got concerts all through the year for all different kinds of music lovers and lovers of great music in particular. So please come and see us again. We'd love to have you. We'd like to leave you with another piece of dance music. It's music from a ballet, and it's called The Dance of the Russian Sailors by a composer from Russia called Reinhold Glier. So if there's any Russian sailors out there tonight, you are going to love this piece of music. Thank you very much and good night.
Thank you.
from that Melbourne audience, that what you just heard, the Glier encore, the Red Poppy Russian Sailors Dance. A wonderful finish to the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra live here at the Myer Music Bowl. And what an evening it has been. A huge thank you to the people that worked so hard to bring you the pristine sound that we have here on ABC Classic. Jack Montgomery Parks, engineer, also Alex Stinson, who engineered this evening, and Russell Thompson as well. And a big thanks to the producer, Jennifer Mills, for this evening's program. It has been an absolute delight to be part of this with you this evening. You can listen back to this. It's a wonderful program. And again, there'll be another one live coming on Valentine's Day.